Welcome to our great show, the YABA TV show. My name is CSC, your host. We are going to take you around the world today. We're going to talk about traveling experiences and people that are in the process of traveling. This is definitely the show to watch. You're not just going to be entertained, but you will learn so much from it. I will talk to a woman who have actually traveled to 46 different countries around the world. Then another person, my other guest, she's traveled to several countries too. We will find out how were they able to adapt to the weather, the food, and the people. So today, our show is very special. Let me start with you, Helen. Where did you go?
Well, I've been to so many countries. And I went to the Africa, start from 1987 mm-hmm. to 46 countries.
Okay. And name some of the countries. Not every one of them.
Yeah, I know. Some country, the name is Ghana. Mm-hmm. I went to the Kenya. Yeah. I like to see the zoo.
Ah,
the yeah, zoo. Because I like nature animals.
Uh-huh.
I like their lifestyle.
Uh-huh.
They're so beautiful.
Wonderful. Where have you been before?
I've been to less countries than she has, but mainly I was born in Nigeria, and I've been to England, France, South Africa, mm-hmm. probably a few other countries on the way, mm-hmm. and of course America, several states within America.
Mm-hmm. You know, the part that I enjoy most when YABA TV does the show, we travel to different countries. When I was in South Africa, they say, are you on holidays? Are you from America? I say, yes. And you know what was funny? As much as I think I have an accent, so I'm sure you all can relate to that, they thought I was American. Welcome to our special program, the YABA TV show. My name is CSC, your host. Today we're going to take you around Southern California to showcase African cooking. If you love food, this is it. We're going to show you Nigerian food, Ghanaian and Ethiopian cooking. So you are in for a very special treat. Tell everybody you know. Today on the YABA TV show, we're going to see some food.
But when I was in college, when we do our International Day, whenever I make the food, everybody, Americans from all over the world, they eat the food and they love it. In short, I would say I was discovered from college. You get some little seed inside it that is called melon, and we make it. The name of the soup is egusi soup.
Egusi soup.
Yeah.
We're going to find out exactly what they eat egusi soup with in a minute, right?
Yes. You can eat egusi soup with anything. With rice, with pounded yam, with plantain, yam, anything you want to eat it with, you can eat it with. And it's very universal in Nigeria, Ghana, Sierra Leone, like West Africa.
What are you eating?
Pounded yam with ogbono soup.
Can you show our audience how you eat this in Nigeria?
Yes. You wash your hand in the water. You unwrap the plastic wrap to expose the pounded yam. Then you take a bite at a time and dip it in the ogbono soup. And you just take a bite.
Is this something that you can chew?
No. Some people chew it, but I like to swallow it just to swallow. It's more delicious that way.
But where you came from, when you grew up, how did you grow up eating it?
Were you swallow. You swallow it.
Yeah. I see a little boy by your side. Is that your son?
Yes, that's my son. That's Osas.
Are you going to feed him too?
Yes, I will.
That's very different from a contemporary American way of eating. Everybody have their own plates.
Yes.
Is there a reason why you feed your son from the same plate?
Well, we grew up eating together, and sometimes that way I can make sure he finishes food and gets the nutrition that he needs. Uh-huh. And he can feed himself, but I just decide to feed him myself.
A touch of mother's love?
That's it. Yeah, you can say that.
Ah! Hi, this is CSCA with the YABA TV show. Join me and enjoy this moment of the wedding celebration of Mr. and Mrs. Olayemi Olatunji.
Alright, nobody should stop them. Allow them to land to the front. Yes, that's the parents of the bride, pastor and reverend. Yes.
Back to our beautiful show, the YABA TV show. My name is CSCA, your host. Today we have something very special for you. As a matter of fact, you may want to take note because when it comes to child naming ceremony in Africa, particularly Ghana, it's very unique. We are going to show you today two people from Ghana, from Fanti ethnic group and Ashanti ethnic group. Both of them are going to tell you their differences and how possibly they all come together to do that thing called naming a child in Ghana. So let me introduce my guest of today's show. Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Let me start with you, Joseph. As a Fanti man from Ghana, you look Ghanaian enough. Thank you for showing us your costume, the sandals, and the wraparound. Before I actually get into today's topic, let's talk about the costume you're wearing. What does this costume represent?
Well, many cases, especially among the Fantis, whenever there's anything traditionally, this is what we put on. Mm-hmm. So that's you call etam. Etam means, you know, this is a cloth that you wrap it on, mm-hmm, to signify your position within the traditional group. Mm-hmm. Because we don't want to look the European type, mm-hmm, but then when it comes to tradition, that's what signifies you as a typical traditional man.
The sandal, I know, is not a regular or a contemporary type you see every day around. What does it mean if you have a fabric wrap around like this and then you wear something different? Would it give you a different look, a different meaning, a different title?
Well, definitely it will give you a different look because people will say, oh, where does it come from? Because normally certain things has to go in the traditional way. Mm-hmm. When you put on the wrap, you're supposed to go with the, you know, the traditional sandals. Mm-hmm. And this is why I put on this one, because I wouldn't like to put on the British sandals to look a little bit awkward. Mm-hmm. So once you put on this, it's just like a lady also dressing.
It gives you the completion.
Complete, yeah.
Fanti man.
Fanti man, thank you.
So, for the Fantis that are watching the show today, I'm sure they are like very excited.
Very.
Say one word to them in Fanti.
Oh, one from the my the sandals. No, we try really good.
And what have you just said?
Oh, I'm telling you to watch me because I'm in my typical traditional outfit.
And I'm representing you.
That's correct.
Right. Pastor Steve, tell us a little bit, not just about yourself, but the Ashanti cultures.
Well, the Ashanti culture actually goes way back in history. We had the Ashanti Empire, mm-hmm, which covered a greater part of West Africa. and I shrank into maybe 1/4 of the Ghanaian region today. And their history goes way back. Mm-hmm. I mean, way back. Ashantis are very proud of the culture because of their background and the political positions they occupied in times of old, which dates way back to thousands of years.
Mm-hmm. I've been to Ghana and I know the king, the royalty of Ghanaian Ashanti king. He has a stool, he has a particular place he lives. And when you talk about gold, solid gold, that's the world is yet to discover. It's there. Some things are unspoken, but the Ashanti king really has a royalty, the respect people pay to him, and the things that he does and how he does it with the costume of gold from head to toe. Talk to me about that, please.
Their position is actually stationed on gold. And what I mean by that is that the seat of the king, which is Manshia, mm-hmm. that is the palace, just like the White House, mm-hmm. Is not far from Obuasi. Obuasi is, I believe, the second to South Africa in gold mining. Hmm. And so the Ashanti Kingdom actually was built on gold. And so gold has become a part of the fabric of their traditions. And that is why they put such emphasis on gold.
Mm-hmm. I know they have a word called Ashantihini. Am I pronouncing it right?
Uh-huh.
What does that mean?
Ashantihini simply means the king of Ashanti.
And then they also have something they say, Ashanti Kotoko.
Ashanti Kotoko is the slogan.
Uh-huh.
Kotoko uh-huh. is a slogan. And again, it goes back to depict the warrior mentality of the Ashantis. Uh-huh. Kotoko simply means Kotoko, which means guerrilla warfare. Uh-huh. You bow down, you dodge, and you keep going. Kotoko.